surveiller à ce que tout reste exactement tel quel.
We should resume course to Anticosti, Captain.
Indeed. The chasseur is waiting for us.
The sea between here and Anticosti is rough, Captain. The Morrigan seems sturdy enough for the challenge.
Rudder wakes to the wind!
Loose sail! Without arch and take!
Some sort of cargo there, sir!
Ships ahoy!
More fishermen from Perse.
The boat patrols these waters closely, Captain.
Enemy ships!
They're sinking the fishing boats.
You must believe those fishermen strayed into their waters.
These cowards must pay!
And would you look at that? Standing right in our way to Anticosti. What say you? You sink every last one of them?
For once, I find myself agreeing with you, Shay.
Stranger things have happened. Maybe he'll have the whole thing figured out for us.
And maybe I'm Emperor of Rome.
Ave Caesar! Salt air, open skies. A man out on the ocean. He's as free as a man can be. What do you say, Liam?
We're out here for a reason, Shay. Mind your duty.
Well, what's the point of freedom if you cannot breathe deep and enjoy it?
Can't we stick to this cockpit like tar? I won't feel liberated until we pry them off.
Seems to me we should just talk to them like men, instead of skulking around.
And would you smile and wish them a good day as they lay their boot on your neck?
Of course not.
They're murdering bastards who want to control the world and everyone in it. Never forget.
And we have nothing in common with that, of course.
Trim sharp to the wind.
Aboard! Or
50 yards off the wind.
There it is. Anticosti.
The chasseur should be there. And with any luck, he will know where to find that manuscript.
The royals and tops! Crew up!
Dock the ship here, Captain. We've arrived at Anticosti Island.
See, that's not rum. It's eau de vie. What the devil is that?
Whiskey. Well, the whiskey here is terrible. I'll shove this boot up your ass, but I'll
you're the weak maker.
So, Louis Joseph. How goes the fur trade?
Not well enough to put beef on my family's plates.
If you want beef, raid more British brigs. They're loaded down with barrels.
Oh, yes. Their Irish farms yield much meat, don't they? Now, that is smart management. Far better than the locals could do.
Take a look at this. I borrowed these plans from a Royal Navy ship of the line. They are like nothing I have ever seen.
Good. We could use some more powerful weapons. Le Chasseur, allow me to present our associate, Shay Cormac.
Gentlemen, I have news. On this same ship, I spied the manuscript you seek. It was written in an exotic language I did not recognize and was full of drawings, plants, and animals out of an opium dream.
Were there no charts, no maps?
No. There may have been some kind of code, but neither I nor the roast beefs could ken it.
Where is the manuscript now?
The man who brought it said a man named Washington sent him.
I know that name. He's an important Templar, isn't he?
He is. Lawrence Washington has great ambitions that Templars have helped fulfill. Shay, let's return and find him. You, sir, have our thanks.
I like it. So what's our next heading?
Wherever this Lawrence Washington docks is ours.
Liam, you're finally getting into the spirit of things.
He's a temper and a politician. What's there to like?
Good.
Hoist anchor! Where does Chevalier get off ordering us around like that? We're assassins, same as him.
He's more experienced and he knows his waters better, Shen. That makes him in charge in these parts.
Well, he commands me around back at the homestead too. Is he a truffle pig to know land better than me?
Show some respect, Shay.
He ought to respect me, Liam. I stick my neck out as much as any of us.
Yeah, twice as often, it seems. That's just the thing. Chevalier hangs back and thinks before making a decision. His experience has earned him that right.
I wonder how much more experience I'll need before I can decide when to wake up or take action. I swear, Liam, sometimes I feel I was more grown up when we were children. We slept rough and scrounged for meat, but at least we decided where and when.
Get up, Jack Johnson, down. Come along, come along, be jolly brave boys, there's plenty more. Frog in the jar, we'll flap.
Loose main sails! Crowd on every inch of sail!
Loose tops and royals!
Over there, Captain. The fishing settled the Greystones. The French took over after it was ransacked.
Some sort of cargo there, sir!
Well, the anchor's on board and our ranks are
well,
sail.
Home in 2 bands. Heads
up. Came Liverpool Julies, we'll never forget.
Blues up! These are sticks!
Douse the mizzen tops!
Goodbye, me sweetheart! Goodbye, me hero! O'Reilly-o!
Hold them in! Get off the wind!
Well, the rain in it.
Can't he walk like the rest of us?
Templars desire to understand the nature of these artifacts. Their spies have called upon many doctors and other learned people in New York.
They have also approached many tribes with questions.
Yeah, they've been showing that manuscript far and wide. No one can read the strange writing or understand the images. We do have a name, though.
We learned that Lawrence Washington sent out the manuscript.
Lawrence Washington, businessman, Virginian politician, and high-ranking Templar.
Ah, yes. I recently heard he was back from the West Indies. One of my men saw his major domo pick up a strange package.
Then that package will be delivered to him promptly. Shay, figure out what it is and find Washington. And when you do, learn all you can.
I'll prepare the Morrigan.
Well, if we've any luck, that ship will lead us right to him.
I make my own luck, Liam. And Washington is running out of his. Get the mains free!
Let loose the mains!
The fort patrols these waters closely, Captain.
Hold down! Hold down!
Bank in sight, sir. Good hunting ground.
Loose and trim too!
Raise those sheets! Let's move! Cargo! Cast the drift, Captain!
Ease off the wind! Haul it all sail!
Who up top?
Douse the mains!
Ha!
Careful! Aye. That's quite a rough squall, Captain!
There she is! All right, men. Time to be quiet.
Lawrence Washington is a powerful businessman, a slave owner, and a leading Templar. We lost track of him about a year ago. I recently learned he was in Barbados, but I haven't been able to confirm that. Now
you think he had something to do with the theft of the artifacts, don't you?
I wouldn't put it past him. Haiti's a short voyage from Barbados, and his return to the colony certainly coincides with the arrival of the artifacts.
We cannot let the Templars get control of these colonies. Whatever happens, Lawrence Washington must not survive.
I'll make sure he doesn't. Also. Aye. There she is! All right, man. Time to be quiet.
Lawrence Washington is a powerful businessman, a slave owner, and a leading Templar. We lost track of him about a year ago. I recently learned he was in Barbados.
Hello,
I haven't
lads.
Been able to confirm
Loose
that.
Loose the royals!
Now
you think he had something to do with the theft of the artifacts, don't you?
I wouldn't put it past him. Haiti's a short voyage from Barbados, and his return to the colony certainly coincides with the arrival of the artifacts.
We cannot let the Templars get control of these colonies. Whatever happens, Lawrence Washington must not survive.
I'll make sure he doesn't.
Holding cargo!
A blockade, Captain!
This won't do. Shay, you must follow that ship on land.
I'll do that. Bring the Morrigan around another way.
Aye, Captain. Track that package and find Washington.
Barrels!
Sub-blockade. And remember what I said, Shay. Washington must die.
Aye.
done hiding in here, are you? Eat food for the dogs.
What's this? A rifle?
You there!
Stay!
Where are you?
How can that be? It makes no sound. Thanks for the present, Master Washington. This is a strange surprise. Not quite what I was expecting. Now I must find Washington and interrogate him.
coming through.
Again with the noise!
I need to get to Washington first. Then I'll worry about the artifacts.
Are you sure you shouldn't be in bed?
I am fine, George. Be a good host for my sake. Go to the wine cellar and get something special for our guests.
I will. Gentlemen?
My brother is a bright spot in a troubled land. If I may make one request before I depart this life, please leave him in peace. He should have nothing to do with the troubles of the Templar cause.
We all respect that sentiment, sir.
You have my thanks, gentlemen. Master Smith, are you ready to leave on your voyage?
Aye, sir. I shall return with answers.
Master Wardrop, are you likewise engaged with the manuscript?
Yes, sir. We'll soon know its meaning.
Then I bid you take your leave.
Washington can barely stand on his own two feet.
Better be right about him, Liam. Because I'm about to murder a dying man.
Too late, assassin.
It's never too late to ruin Templar plans, Master Washington.
But my plans are already in motion. Even leading you here has given my allies time to escape. Thank you for making my end a quick one.
And thank you for revealing your master plan, you scheming snake. God damn it. I better hurry.
Liam, I hope you brought the ship around. That's a shit mortar! That's not sported!
Lawrence Washington is dead.
You look disappointed.
The sickly way that man looked. He would have been dead in a month anyway. Two other Templars got away. They're looking into the manuscript and box.
Did they have the artifacts?
I don't know. Perhaps. I can't be sure.
Then you did what was right by the Brotherhood. Find the object, Lee. Cheer up, Shay. A rare day we can sow such chaos among the Templars.
Perhaps. But to hear Washington speak, it didn't sound like they'd be too put out by the loss.
Well, that's what he'd want you to think.
The memory appears to be fragmented. How much time has passed?
A few months, I think. That virus is cutting off our access to complete memories. They're readable, but messy.
A 7 years' war will soon break out in the colonies. Focus on assassin interference.
We'll do our best. Won't we, numbskull?
It's so grim about the homestead now that Miss Abigail and little Connor have passed.
Aye. I've seen Achilles crying.
Why shouldn't he?
It's just that he doesn't look sad. He looks furious. It's unsettling.
He's struggling with the loss. We all are.
I know. But it's been months. And we've done little but search for this blasted manuscript and box.
The chasseur has a lead on the box. We need him and Chevalier St. John's.
Chevalier too? No hope of cheering me up, then.
When Achilles said whoever had the artifacts could access sites of great power, what did he mean?
I'm not sure I understand it myself, sir. I've long thought that it was.
He believes the box can be activated to, well, project words or images.
Like a magic lantern?
What do you mean?
You know the magic lantern shows Father Connolly put on in the church basement? The box had a candle in it, I think. He put these little glass plates in front. Then we'd see the images projected on the wall, like cathedrals in Rome. Bright and near as big as life.
Ah, yeah. I suppose it is. Except that it interprets the strange language of the manuscript, too. If the plate were of a banner in Latin, you'd see it in English.
How is that possible?
Who knows? I fear we might never truly understand how any of the pieces of Eden work.
Where in the world has the most beautiful girls?
I suppose it depends on your vision of beauty. A damsel from Corfu and one from Oslo are as different as chalk and cheese, but both could be lovely.
See, opinions like that give a man a reputation for wisdom.
Yeah, thank you.
I would have just said Havana. The girls there have lusty buttocks and bosoms and feel no shame in putting them on display. But that's no slight against our lasses from home.
I suppose.
I think Galway has the nicest ones. Fair and modest. Always willing to spot you a penny for an ale.
You don't say.
And then there's the maids I met in Lisbon. Destined for the convent they were. Dark-eyed and kindly dispositioned. If only I'd spoke Portuguese. Not that we spent much of our nights talking.
Opinions like that give a man an entirely different reputation. Almost there, Captain. Le Chasseur will be expecting us.
And Chevalier.
That's a small price to pay for a lead in the precursor box.
I never thought I'd say this to a complete stranger, but I owe you my life.
ces Anglais.
Il n'y a rien à voir. Va-t'en. Il n'y a rien. Fiche-moi.
Les combats ont beau avoir éclaté dans les colonies, ils se propageront forcément à l'Europe.
Guerre à l'échelle mondiale, c'est un petit rec.
Good day's hunting.
Through the ice.
Safe in our tops! Close down! Catch some wind! Ease off the wind! All sail! She'll take it!
Ready for your trip down!
Unfurled mains! Let's move!
As I walked down on Broadway one evening in July, I met a maid who had betrayed an assailant shot, and I added no way you stand in.
Stormcat! Looks bad!
What's on your mind, Captain? Rum bit of business, that.
captain's trick!
Let out some sail!
That wind's trouble, Captain Cormac.
Some sort of cargo there, sir.
There's the gallatin!
Well, our anchors on board and our axes are set.
Already on
coming against us! Quite a rough squall, Cap.
Reefing all tops. Crowded all out. Douse the royals and tops! Get them aloft! Douse on sight!
Thank you.
Loose mainsails!
Raise those sheets! Let's move!
More sail! All sail!
Who's down? Man your sheets!
Sails into the wind! Ease off the wind! Loose the...
Well, our anchor's on board and our eggs are set.
Oh, radio, boom, alay.
Dame Liverpool Julie's will never forget.
Oh, radio, gone away. Goodbye, me darling. Goodbye, me dear. Oh, radio, boom, alay. Goodbye, me sweetheart. Goodbye, me dear. Oh, radio, gone away.
Well, the rain, it is raining all the day long.
O'Reilly,
oh, glues up! These are sticks!
Northern
right away!
Bring up the ropes!
give me some speed!
Loose sail! Put out all she'll take!
As we were fishing, the haze grows
some high. Sort of cargo shoot there, sir!
And pulling and trolling all night in that windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all hold together. When up jumped a herring, the queen of the sea, says now, old skipper, you cannot catch me. In the windy old weather, stormy old weather.
Thank you.